So I want to first start, and I know you're going to hear a lot of thank yous this weekend. Every time you go to a rest stop, the volunteers are going to thank you. Every time you go anywhere during the next 3 days, people are going to say thank you. And it's so well deserved. But I want to be the first, on behalf of the entire organization, to express our gratitude and say thank you for everything you've done to get to this point tonight. Give yourselves a round of applause. I want to give a special thanks to our funding partners. As all of you know, Pelotonia is able to invest 100% of every single dollar we raise in cancer research because of the individuals and companies who underwrite all of the overhead to enable that 100% commitment. Let's give our funding partners a huge round of applause. I also want to thank our board for their leadership and their vision and their creativity. Without them, none of this would be possible. I also want to thank our team, our interns, our staff, people that get up every single day with one goal in mind, changing the world for millions of people affected by cancer. And it's an honor to go to work with them every day. So let's give them a huge round of applause. I also want to acknowledge all of the researchers and scientists who are here, many of whom are wearing shirts that say, "You have funded my research." If you could stand up and raise your hand, if you are doing cancer research at the James on behalf of millions of people, let's give them a huge round of applause. Look at them in the red shirts. I also want to acknowledge the incredible men and women from law enforcement and emergency services who are not only keeping us safe here tonight at the Commons, but throughout the ride tomorrow and Sunday will keep all of us safe. Let's give a huge round of applause for men and women in uniform. Yes, you can go now. This is my daughter, Clara. You want to wave? Wave. And this is my son, Sam. Come on out, buddy. Future rider. So, you know, this weekend is about celebrating. It's about honoring people that we know and love. And as with every year at Pelotonia, there are people who unfortunately can't be here tonight or who are no longer with us. People like Ray McInnes, people like Dusty Fultz, people like Dan Weisenbach, so many others who we will ride for tomorrow and Sunday. And I want everybody to spend this weekend thinking about those people in your life that have been touched by this disease that you're honoring through your participation, through your fundraising, and ultimately, the research you are making possible will change the outcome for so many people in the future. We've got a bunch of special guests tonight, and tonight's program is really focused on the impact that you are creating because of your participation. First person I want to bring out is somebody who has ridden Pelotonia many years with his brother, with his son. He'll be out there tomorrow riding 100 miles again. Please help me welcome to the stage United States Senator Rob Portman.
Thank you, Doug.
Good, buddy. How you doing? Good to see you.
Doug, thank you for your leadership. Doug is a survivor, he gets it. Nearly 8,000 strong this year. How about that, folks? Yeah. As you're riding by me on the Century Ride, say hello. I am here with my brother, I'm here with my son, and we're here because my mom died way too young of a cancer that was considered incurable. As I talk to people who are in remission from multiple myeloma today, they tell me, "Rob, it's too bad she didn't contract it about 6 or 7 years later." Another way to look at that is to say it's too bad that we didn't have this ride 6 or 7 years earlier, and that the researchers were able to figure out what they later were able to find to be able to save lives and allow people to live full, productive lives. That's what we're here for, right? So I went to the James today again, and I went there again to say, okay, what's new? How is all this money being used? Because this year again, folks, you will raise, we will raise over $20 million. Think about that. Nobody else in the country is doing this. And thanks to the corporate sponsorships, it all goes to this research, and they told me story after story of how our money is being used. I'll give you one example, a relatively small stipend, about $10,000, ended up with this discovery that may be commercialized, that may be able to help thousands of people with throat and cervical cancer. I'll tell you about another one. $4 million of what we raised has gone to allow over 250 undergraduate and grad students to come in and do research, and they said these kids in their 20s have actually the best ideas. They take risks, and some of these risks really pay off. They said about $1 we raise is leveraged for about $20 of funding at the federal level, some of this NIH funding that we're using at the James. What you're doing is amazing. Thank you. Dr. Caligiuri today was able to tell me all about this because he has built this incredible team of researchers in part because of the excitement of this ride. And Dr. Drake, of course, is a medical guy, so it turns out the president of Ohio State totally gets it. He's also a guy who understands that for families all across Ohio, middle-income families, they need to have access to education. He's done an awesome job in ensuring that people have access to the Ohio State University. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Drake.
I don't know if I'm supposed to.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. OH! All right, great to be here tonight. Great to be here every year to see so many people out preparing for the great ride that we do tomorrow. There are wonderful things that happen on the ride that we all see. First, the thousands of people who come out to support us all, the thousands of volunteers that make it happen, all connected in a single community with one end in sight, and that is to end cancer. So it's a wonderful thing to come together and to work for. So that's one of the reasons that this is a great event. Another is that cycling is a wonderful thing to do. Being healthy is a good thing, and being able to cycle is a great thing. And we have beautiful rolling countryside here around Central Ohio, and it's a wonderful experience to get out there and join with your friends and neighbors and do something that's health promoting and good for all of us. And that's a great thing. And then the final thing that's a really cohesive part of this is the ubiquitous nature of cancer itself. Just, we did this last year, and I'm just curious this year. So, how many people here have a family member, father, mother, sister, brother, or you yourselves have been someone who's suffered with cancer? And you notice that everybody's hand goes up, and you say, well, yeah, everybody's hand goes up because we're here at an event that's for raising money for cancer research. But if you go to a group of adults in the United States anywhere and ask that question, say, has a direct family member or a close friend suffered from, or is one of them battling cancer now, everyone's hand goes up because this is in all families. And so when I ride tomorrow, I think about all of the families that are affected by this disease and what we can do to try to help them all. I think about my father and brother who suffered from cancer and the great success that my father had and my brother's success, which was not so good, and how we want to have good things happen for more and more people. I think of people in our community, John F. Wolfe, who was a great leader in our community. He did so much to build so many things, and this disease just really affects people all over the community. And so anything we can do, day by day, step by step, working with our great scientists and researchers to help push the envelope further and further toward a time when cancer is something we talk about in the past or something that people live with rather than die from, that's a great thing to do. So thank you all so very much for being here and for being there tomorrow. And I have the honor of introducing, and by the way, I'm riding for the third time tomorrow and looking forward to it very much. And so I'll wave when you see me on the road and we can share an OH. And then finally, I wanted to introduce my colleague, Sean Decatur from Kenyon College, who has a few words to say. President Decatur.
Thank you. All of us at Kenyon are looking forward to welcoming riders up the hill to Gambier tomorrow afternoon. We have good food and cold drinks and good music to relax and celebrate after the long ride, and it's really our honor to be able to welcome you and to share that with you tomorrow. You know, Kenyon is a place where we believe strongly in the notion of bringing together a community of people with shared values, engaging in rigorous discourse and problem solving, and that that's a power that really can overcome any obstacle or reach any goal. And so our partnership with Ohio State and the James and Pelotonia is very important to us because it symbolizes so much of what we think the educational experience is all about. You know, this is my fourth year riding in Pelotonia, and it has a particular meaning to me this year because my brother's been having a really tough struggle this year as he goes through a continued fight with cancer. And one of the things that I know that's been important to him is that though he's been fighting through this, he knows he's not fighting alone. He's fighting with the support of his friends and family. He's fighting with the wonderful work of physicians and medical staff and researchers who have helped develop the treatments and therapies that have been so valuable to him for the past few years. And he's also struggling and fighting with all of us because there's so many of us who do our part in order to reach this goal, to win this fight against cancer, to reach the goal of an end to cancer. And so I want to thank all of you personally for participating in this fight. I look forward to riding with you tomorrow, and thank you all very much, and see you up in Gambier at Kenyon. Thanks.
Thank you, President Decatur. For those of you who don't know, he not only rides, and obviously they host hundreds of us tomorrow night, if not thousands of us tomorrow night on their campus, but they also have reached out to their alumni and their students and their supporters to get them more engaged in Pelotonia, which has been phenomenal. So thank you, President Decatur. Thank you, Dr. Drake. So as I mentioned earlier, one of the differentiators of Pelotonia is that 100% of every dollar goes to cancer research. And a lot of that research is really high risk, high reward, looking for transformational breakthroughs, things that will lead to new therapies. And I always like to highlight that there are people here across town tonight who are counting on us. They're counting on us because their friends and their loved ones and their family members are waiting for new clinical trials, are waiting for new breakthroughs and new opportunities to survive this disease. And our next guest knows a little something about that. And before I bring him out, I want to show you a quick video that tells you a little bit about his story. Take a look at the screens.
Chris Draft and Keisha Rutledge met in 2006 when he was playing for the Carolina Panthers. There was an immediate connection.
Chris described Keisha as a beautiful woman who, you know, walks through a room, brings a ton of personality.
But life in the NFL for a journeyman linebacker isn't conducive to settling down. Draft bounced from Carolina to St. Louis, to Buffalo, to Washington, where his career ended in 2010. All the while, Keisha waited.
Was there ever a point which she said, what's the deal?
There was a couple of times. There definitely was.
Well, what would you tell her?
I said, we're getting closer. No, she didn't like to hear that, but we're getting closer.
Finally, in 2010, Chris and Keisha were able to be together all the time. But suddenly, Keisha, a fit 37-year-old, a former dancer with the Charlotte Hornets Honeybees, started having trouble breathing. Despite the fact that she'd never smoked, Keisha was diagnosed with stage 4 lung cancer. The average life expectancy in such cases is 8 months.
You say it one day at a time. But really, we're gonna fight this.
In the face of late-stage cancer, Chris and Keisha's vision of their shared future might have melted away, but it didn't. In August 2011, 8 months after Keisha's initial diagnosis, with her condition worsening, Chris proposed.
You can't guarantee what's tomorrow. You can't do that. It's one more day, I'll take it. Two, I'll take that. Yeah? But to have that with your wife, woman that you love, take me some seconds, if that's it. Give me 60 more seconds.
Within a few weeks of the wedding, Keisha's organs were failing, and her pain was increasing.
we were blessed to be able to have Christmas back here and have all her family came down, so she was able to talk to them. But some battles you just don't win.
When Keisha died on December 27th, Chris was at her side. She was 38. They were married for only 5 weeks, far too briefly. But together, they had made every breath count.
It'd always be a great memory of seeing her walk down the aisle. That consistent fight. Just that each day that she's able to refocus. And to see that type of strength every day. Every day.
Pelotonia community, let's welcome to the stage a dear friend, somebody who spends every day of his life now traveling the country advocating for cancer research, Chris Draft.
Oh man, thank you. Thank you, Doug. It is an absolute pleasure for me to be here. I had a chance to, I met Doug probably about 3 years ago, and we've had a chance to build a great relationship, a great friendship. And when he came up here to Pelotonia, he started talking to me about it. He started telling me that there's something amazing that's happened up here in Columbus. He said, if you didn't know, there's amazing things happening in Columbus. I didn't know it. I didn't know it, so I had to come up and see it. So I came up, I had a chance to visit with the tremendous staff that put this thing together, because you cannot coordinate 8,000, well actually nearly 8,000 people without an amazing staff. Otherwise it might get a little crazy. So yeah, I'm excited to be here, and I'm excited to actually get a chance to soak up this ride. Now there's certain people out there, I don't know where he is. It was trying to challenge me to ride 180 miles. And just so you guys know, I played in the NFL for basically 12 years. I am not riding 180 miles. I'm just throwing that out there. Just in case you guys are looking for me over there, I will be at the 50 section. So all my 50s, where are all the 50s? So you guys saw a little bit of our story. You got a chance to see my wife, and I think it's important that the video plays so you can understand. I mean, like everybody out here, our president of the Ohio State came out here and he talked about everybody having a connection. And it's too true. It's so true. And it's only when you have that connection or that direct connection do you realize that you know nothing. That you really do not know cancer. My wife was diagnosed in December of 2010. And she had lung cancer. Before that, she was challenging me to do P90X with her. She was challenging me to run a 10K with her. You guys know P90X, that thing is serious. And all of a sudden, a little shortness of breath, and she's got lung cancer. And so it's lung cancer, and you find out the most important fact about lung cancer, that anybody can get it. Even a 37-year-old who's a former dancer for the Charlotte Hornets and just amazingly in shape type person, and then you go into this world that is the cancer center. And then you start learning terms like medical oncologists, radiation oncologists, pulmonologists, thoracic surgeons, social workers, just all these terms that you just, biopsies, liquid biopsies, bronchoscopies, things that you now can just say. You got a new vocabulary. And then when you start using that vocabulary around people that you know, they looking at you like you're crazy. Because cancer hasn't touched them that way yet. Now we hope that it doesn't. We hope that they can have a little bit of a knowledge, a little bit of vocabulary, and not have to be so close to it before it's something that's serious. I'm excited about this group here because I know not everybody maybe is right by them, but they understand how important it is that we fight. You understand how important it is that we invest, because it can happen to us. It can happen to anyone. And we can wait till we have to learn more, or we can start doing something about it right now. And you guys are doing something tremendous. Doug told me that this is the biggest race in the country, that you're raising more money. You got sponsors that are over here saying 100% of it. All them sponsors over there are awesome. You guys are something special. Everybody out here that is raising, man, it is just so amazing, because you guys are investing. You're out here and you took a stand. You said, we're going to do something about cancer. We're going to end cancer. And that's great. I mean, we're going to go end it. We're going to go, you know, I'm a linebacker. We're going to go get it. But in going and getting it, what we're really doing is we're raising up people. We're raising up people that are dealing with this disease right now. We're raising up people that are going to deal with this disease. We're trying to give them more time with their families, more time so they can get married, more time so they can go to a graduation, more time so they can just sit out in a park and hang out, more time so they can walk down the street with their husband and their wife, more time where they can get out and ride their bike. That's what you guys are doing. You guys are giving life today. You guys are giving a whole bunch of life. You've got a tremendous cancer center here in the Ohio State, the James, that is leading the way, not just in the country, but in the world. If people don't know it, there's something wrong. But the people here definitely know it. And you guys have shown out, you came out, and you guys have sent a message to cancer. You have sent a strong message to cancer that cancer's in trouble. Because the people of Columbus, the people here in Ohio, the people that came from someplace else here to Columbus, Ohio, aren't playing. They came to end cancer. So thank you guys. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you guys for standing up. Thank you guys for making this a priority. Thank you guys for loving people enough to be here and take a stand. And just thank you guys for allowing me to come up here and talk and really give you guys a little bit of energy, so I know that when I share my wife that she didn't just pass away, that she gets a chance to inspire you guys a little bit as we keep on moving towards beating this thing up. So with that said, I'm almost done. My man Doug gave me an opportunity. He gave me an opportunity. He said there is a video that's going to play. And this video is just going to sum up all the awesomeness that is Palantonian. All the awesomeness that is people from Columbus. All the awesomeness is people from OH. Oh, see that? You know I had to do that. You know I had to do that. Can I do it again? Can I do it again? OH! Oh, my goodness. Do you guys know Orlando Pace? Does anybody know Orlando Pace? Orlando Pace is one of my teammates, and he's going into the Hall of Fame tomorrow. You guys know that. So he's over in Canton. He's over in Canton. Yo, I wish he could be here. I don't know if there's a bike big enough for him. He might have had to ride like three of them and string them together. But let's see if Big O can hear us in Canton. Are you guys ready? We're trying to make it where Big O over in Canton can hear us. OH! OH! Doug, can we get a video?
It began with one goal.
One goal, end cancer.
One goal to end cancer.
Just one goal, end cancer.
Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome Mr. Tom Lennox, your executive director. He will be leading our riders out here as
what started as a grassroots bike tour quickly became a powerful social movement. The money raised has gone to new treatment innovations, fund the best and brightest researchers, and deliver new therapies through clinical trials to patients in need.
One of my best friends was diagnosed and treated with Hodgkin's, and you know, they gave me back one of my best friends.
Strap your helmets on, get on the bikes, as we will be starting Pelotonia.
It was such a long day, and I mean, we were in the rain and the sun, and it was just such an experience.
This year, we have over 6,200 riders. We have over 3,700 virtual riders.
Absolutely exhausted.
Pelotonia is not simply a fundraiser. It is an experience. 100% of every dollar we raise goes directly to research.
We've recruited well over now 100 physicians, scientists, and physician scientists solely dedicated to cancer research right here to The Ohio State University.
Pelotonia has absolutely become everything that we dreamed it would be and more.
If you are here tonight, you've done something that has positively impacted the lives of people that you will never meet. And for that, we are eternally grateful.
You gotta do it. I mean, it's one of the best things that I've ever done in my entire life.
In the next three decades, we're not gonna see cancer. We're gonna develop the cancer-free world. And that's really where Pelotonia comes in.
We are just getting started, and we can't stop now. Tomorrow morning, you'll hit the road and take off on a journey with thousands of your fellow riders by your side from 8 countries and 40 states. Each and every one of you has a story you brought to this movement. All of you have your own reasons to ride and raise. Tomorrow, we stick together with one goal: end cancer.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage your CEO of the James, Dr. Caligiuri.
Woo! Amazing video, amazing people. Give everyone a round of applause, please. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, listen, I want to say thank you to you, and I want you to answer with a "you're welcome," because I want you to hear the thank you sincerely from all of us. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you all so much, all that you're doing to help us. I've got so much to talk about, got so little time. Want to just tell you about a couple incredible things. You know, since I was up here last time, we went through this amazing review of our Comprehensive Cancer Center at The Ohio State University. We hand in a 2,000-page application every 5 years. And I'll be honest with you, 15 years ago, we didn't do so well. A perfect score is a 10. Get as close to that as you can. We'd gotten a 20. 5 years later, we had gotten like a 15. 5 years later, we got like a 13. And about 5 years ago, we got a 12. So we're moving towards that perfect 10 score. So you put this 2,000-page application together. You get about 50 experts from around the world who read it. They take 6 months to read it. They look at all of your science, all that you've done, who you've recruited, what discoveries you've made. Have you changed the landscape of how cancer is prevented and treated? And they come in and they interview us for 2 days about what we've done, what our vision is, where we're going. We did this last year. In this December, we got our score. And I can tell you that to the best of anyone's knowledge, we are the first university
in the United States of America to get a perfect 10 score from the National Cancer Institute. Perfect score. And guess why? Guess why we got a perfect score? Because you decided to volunteer, you decided to virtual ride, you decided to ride, and we had new research, new dollars to push the research further and further. And our nation recognized that and gave our Comprehensive Cancer Center a score of exceptional and a perfect score of 10. So thank you. Thank you. And you know, I'd love to go through you the hundreds of examples we gave them about how we've changed the landscape to cure and prevent cancer. And I'll just tell you one. 4 years ago, you allowed us to take $4 million and really go out and find 51 hospitals to help us with an experiment, high risk. We had discovered a gene which causes hereditary colon cancer. That means if you have this gene, if you have this gene and you're inherited from your mother or your father, you've got an 85% chance of getting colon cancer. So we took $4 million, went to 51 hospitals throughout the state of Ohio, and we said, send us a sample of your colon cancer, and we'll check it for the gene. Well, as you can imagine, about 1 out of 30 people have this hereditary colon cancer from mom or dad. And we found hundreds of people that didn't know they had the gene, but they did. So you know what we were able to do? We were able to send our genetic counselors out there, because you paid for it, do all the genetic counseling, find all the family members that had the gene but didn't yet have the cancer. And through colonoscopy, through navigation, getting people to the right place, we're able to prevent each and every one of those people, some in their teenage years, some in their 20s and their 30s, who were destined to get colon cancer, who carry this gene, who now, because of you, are never, ever going to get colon cancer. Thank you. Not only that, you gave us $4 million. Do you know how many life years we saved from those hundreds of people that have the gene that would have died? 800 years of life. Thank you. And to our governor and to our federal representatives, we spent $4 million. If those cancers would have occurred, it would have cost all of us $40 million. So a little money into prevention, into genetics, into research can change the landscape of cancer forever. So thank you very, very much. And lastly, you remember I told you about a disease that was a death sentence. A disease for which you had to have lots of chemotherapy, sometimes a bone marrow transplant, and always fatal. And I told you about a drug called ibrutinib, which we got a hold of, and two of our great researchers, who I'm going to invite up here on the stage, and many, many members of their team, got to work on it right away. Had no idea that it would work in cancer, but they put it to work, and they found that not only does it work in cancer, but 92% of people who take this pill, no chemo, no transplant, go into complete remission. 92%, and they stay in remission. So I want to bring up two of those researchers that you funded through Pelotonia, Amy Johnson and John Bird. Doctors, come on up. Woo! So here they are. They received your $100,000, and this drug got FDA approved, went worldwide, and thousands of people are taking it today. Well, I want to bring somebody up here, somebody they don't know is here, somebody who came here from a great distance, somebody who's a first-time rider, somebody who's a survivor because of these two people, and raised $20,000 for her first-time ride. Please welcome Susan Davenport. Susan, come on up. Woo!
Thank you, Debbie. Well, I don't know about you, but I'm ready to get it. So here we go. My name is Susan Davenport, and I am a Kansas Jayhawk living in Northern Virginia. So how in the heck did I get here? Well, I've got a story for you. I'm not a Buckeye, but I happen to love one. And since Columbus is the mothership for the Buckeye Nation, whenever an opportunity presents itself to come back to town, my favorite Buckeye starts a sales pitch. About 4 years ago, the pitch to come to Pelotonia started at our house. And for whatever reason, we just couldn't make it work. This year, we were determined it would be different. So right after registration opened, we signed up and we committed to ride. In that moment, you're overwhelming me. In that moment, we had zero idea of the personal debt that we owe Pelotonia, the James, and these two people and their team because of what they've done. Unbelievably, I've been fighting cancer for 16 years, and in that time, I've endured what I think I and most others would consider pretty brutal treatment. After years of that, my body and my spirit were tired. And so not long ago, I made the decision that I wanted to stop treatment altogether and try to have a life, no matter what the ultimate cost. My oncologist, on the other hand, had a different idea. There's this drug, he said. You take it orally. It's showing great promise for people like you. And best of all, it doesn't have all the horrible side effects that you've been experiencing. I agreed to take the drug, and it literally changed my life. So here's the part that gets me every time. It wasn't until after we had agreed to ride in Pelotonia that we learned that my drug, my miracle drug, the drug that had given me back my life and was giving me hope when I had lost it, was developed at OSU CCC, and it was funded, the research was funded 100% by Pelotonia funds. So back to my original question, how the heck did I get here? I'm in here in Columbus at Pelotonia on this stage because of you. So let that sink in a little bit. A decision that you made to get on a bike and go for a ride and raise a few dollars for a great cause while you're at it is responsible for saving a life, my life. And how can I possibly put into words what this ride and all of you riders, both virtual and those who will share the road with me tomorrow, volunteers, sponsors, the city of Columbus, and the incredible folks at the James mean to me personally. Saying thank you just doesn't seem enough, but it's all that I have. So I thank you, each of you, from the bottom of my heart. You know, next year, 5 years, 10 years from now, there's going to be someone else standing on this stage telling us the story of a life that was saved because of what this community of people accomplished this weekend. And I am so incredibly proud to be a part of that. And I hope you are as well. I hope you have a great ride tomorrow. And if you see me and Ruby out on the road, Ruby is my bike and she happens to be emerald green. So if you see me and Ruby out on the road tomorrow, I would love to have the opportunity to meet you and say hello and say thank you. Thank you for saving my life.
Susan Davenport, let's hear it. Mike, John, Amy, and Susan, thank you, thank you, thank you. So this weekend is the culmination of your incredible fundraising efforts that started in January. And the money is simply a means to the impact. And you just heard from Susan the ultimate impact that you have enabled. So we want you to have fun this weekend. We want you to be safe and follow the rules of the road. And we want you to think about the people you're riding for. On Sunday, I'm going to celebrate 20 years since my initial cancer diagnosis, but I'm going to ride for a young man named Louis Becker. And every mile and every pedal stroke, I'm going to think about what he and his family have endured. And I'd ask you, while you're out there, to continue to think about why you signed up in January or February or March, why you've had bake sales, why you've sold t-shirts, why you've asked your friends and family to invest in this cause. Because we'll have hours on the road to share those stories with one another, and it's this community that has the opportunity to continue to change the world for people just like Susan Davenport. So on behalf of our team, we hope you have an incredible weekend, whether you're riding one day or two, whether you're volunteering or participating in another form or fashion. We are so indebted, so grateful, and we'll see you all on the road tomorrow. Have a great night.